Farina is an exclusive partner for the kitchen sector with Snydero since 1990. How do you build such a long and strong relationship?
Well, first of all, it's important to say that Snyder is the only one kitchen manufacturer in the world, partner of Pininfarina, and has been for 30 years. So we have put the maximum of our know-how and our passion and competence in favor of Snyder for many years. I think we made the right choice, because Snyder is the right partner, because we share the same values that are, let's say, competence, commitment, and quality. Quality of the projects, quality of the products, solid quality. So that is the secret for a long-term relationship.
Pininfarina is known for being a trendsetter, not a follower. How do you apply this philosophy in the kitchen sector?
Well, I like to take as an example the first project that was the Ola in 1990, because we follow the same attitude in the following projects through the years. But the first one in 1990 was the result of the intuition of the founder of Snyder, Rino Snyder, who said, "I want to do something really innovative, something breakthrough, mixing a designer coming from another world." So creating a sort of contamination between kitchen cabinets and design, automotive design. So two different worlds, two different stories and experiences mixed to create the innovation. And actually, the Ola was a product that was never been made before. It was absolutely, totally revolutionary. And you can do this if you take some risk. So I like to say that you have to take a reasonable risk of innovation. Otherwise, you will be always a follower, and you will never create a new trend. You will never be a trendsetter. You will always be just a follower.
Which details from the automotive sector you have applied in a real kitchen?
Well, in general, we took the round shapes. We took the round shapes, the round surfaces, and the quality of the paint, the metallic paint. But the round shapes, because of safety, because we always wanted to design for well-being, and the safety of the user was always in our mind from the very beginning. So we never designed kitchens with edges, offensive. But always our details are rounded for safety. And let's say details like the handles, for example, they reflect the interior of all the automobiles. But more in general, when we try to hide details and leave it clean, essential and pure, then we transfer the purity of a good automotive design in the world of the kitchen. And actually, we created a Pininfarina line step by step. So the identity of Snydero in the sector of innovation and, let's say, futuristic part, size of the market, is strongly tied with Pininfarina.
Both Pininfarina and Snydero are two icons of Made in Italy and Italian style. What do you think? What is the future of Made in Italy?
Well, the future of Made in Italy is maybe bright if we can put in evidence the history, because we have a history and a tradition that our competitors in the Far East, for example, do not have. So the history of the man, the commitment through the generations to the quality and reliability, the craftsmanship. So there is a lot of stories to tell, and the Italian brands may be winning on the market. Of course, we need to have the technology, we need to have the innovation, we need to have the quality and everything, the recyclability, the sustainability. But the history and the passion of the people can make the difference.
What is your vision for the future of the kitchen?
Well, the future of the kitchen is similar to the future of architecture, design and interior design, more in general. So I think that the future is a consequence of the pandemic. That, in my mind, can be an opportunity to redesign the products and to redesign the environments, like redesign the house. And I have the idea of, besides sustainability and circular economy and all the technology and domotics, yes, but I think that the real challenge is the inside out. Mm-hmm. That is the interior and the exterior. That is the house, the room and the terrace or the balcony. Mm-hmm. So to mix up the two areas and to live in the two areas with a furniture that is flexible and you can configure it in two different ways depending on the season. So the exterior becomes warmer in the winter and cooler in the summer and vice versa. So, so you can really live your house for your well-being with inside and outside. And that is a real great opportunity for architects, because you have to think of how to live. That means how to protect yourself from the weather, to protect from the cold, to protect from the hot, from the rain and the wind. So it's a fantastic challenge. A problem, that is the pandemic, creates the opportunity and a strong challenge for creative people.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.